guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lisa, and in today's video, I'm filming a super, super highly requested hair video, which is on my entire hair care routine. So ever since September, I've really, really changed up my hair routine ever since I really incorporated a lot of Verb products. If you guys follow me on Instagram and on YouTube, this will not be the first time that I'm talking about Verb. You guys know how much I love this brand. They're literally one of my very favorite hair brands. I owe them so much for kind of just changing the way that I love my own natural hair. So before I go into the video, I just want to say thank you to Verb for sponsoring this video. And as usual, I have 10% off all of their products. So you can check out the link down below for the discount. If you guys have been following me from a long time ago, I used to heat my hair every single day. Ever since I started using their products, I've absolutely changed my entire routine. I now haven't actually even touched heat in close to 6 months, the occasional 1 or 2 days. But in today's video, I'm actually gonna be doing a end-to-end hair care to show you guys my everyday hair routine as well as my occasional hair routine as well, because I don't use all these products every single time. Some of these products are not meant for every single hair wash, so I'm just gonna be running you through all the hair products. Okay, so the way that I thought I would structure this video is to go through my usual hair routine, the hair routine that I use all the time, beginning to end, every time I wash my hair. And then I'm gonna go through the products that I use, you know, once a week, a few times a wash, or etc., or like as a per needed basis. To start off with my usual every wash routine, obviously we have shampoo and conditioner. And if you guys are not new to my YouTube videos, you guys know that I actually switch my shampoo and conditioner after I finish up the shampoo and conditioner, or if I'm trying and reviewing a new product every month. I've just been trained by my mom that it's just healthier that way, to switch up your shampoos and conditioners every single time you're done using it, so you're not using the exact same product. I've used a lot of the Verb line, and honestly, my biggest recommendation to you is to shop by use, depending on what your hair is like. So if you have curly hair, if you have really fine and silky hair, or if your hair is really dry because you bleached it, I would definitely shop by need when it comes to your shampoo and conditioner. So in this rotation, this time round, I'm actually using one of their new lines, which they're launching, which is the Full Body Color Safe and Cleanse Shampoo and Conditioner. This is what the bottles look like. All of their bottles are just super cute and really easy to use. I actually fit a lot of their shampoo and conditioner, I guess, like requirements. The hydrating line, I used it and loved it because I actually have pretty dry hair from the bleaching. The curl one really helps my waves. The Ghost shampoo and conditioner, just kind of like an everyday shampoo. And then this one is just super good for helping boost up my volume a little bit. Honestly, depending on your hair texture, I really, really recommend checking out their different lines of shampoo and conditioner. So after I shampoo and conditioner my hair, when I get out of the shower, I will dry my hair, and I will then go in with my holy grail product. I don't think I can live without this product, you guys. I think if I had to go to a desert island and bring one product, it would literally be this product. This is now my second bottle, and as you can see, I'm almost done. But this is the Verb Shape and Define Curl Cream. This is what it looks like. So I just put on a lot, actually, more than the usual recommended amount. But I like to put on a lot on my towel dry hair because I feel like it really, really brings out my waves and holds it really, really well. If you guys are looking for something to hold your either natural waves or natural curls, I really recommend this product. It's honestly just my holy grail, and it just does so well. Look at this. This is my hair. After I use the curl cream, I will actually use a little bit of mousse. So the one that I'm using right now is the My Hair My Canvas Mousse. This is what the mousse looks like. I actually prefer the Joico Extra Hold Mousse, which I will leave a picture here. It's like the silver bottle that you guys can purchase from Shoppers or any drugstore. The only difference between these two and why I have this one is because I was trying this product, and although I love it, I just feel like I have to use a little bit more. And I think it also depends on preference, because if you want more of like a wetter look and a more, I guess, like crunchy wetter look, go with the Joico Strongholds. But with this one, it's a little bit more natural. I prefer the more defined, wetter, crunchier look. So that's why I prefer the Joico one over this one a little bit, because I have to use a lot more of this product. But on days when I just want to have like a softer look, then I would use this product instead. So it just really depends on, you know, what you prefer as a look in terms of the mousse. After the mousse, I actually go in with the Curl Leave-In Conditioner, and this is part of their Curl line. So once again, these two kind of come together. I use this because I've actually tried just using this product before. Even though it holds my curls really well, my hair will still be quite frizzy, and the only thing to defrizz it is not even the mousse, but the leave-in conditioner. Make sure, you know, you have wavy hair, curly hair, whatever, you need to buy their leave-in conditioner. This is what makes it look super silky and not really frizzy. And also, if you guys are wondering why I don't just use the curl cream or just use the mousse, I don't know, I just find that after so much trial and error, having a mousse on top of the curl cream makes it even more like crisp. That's just my own personal recommendation. The next product that I actually use in my hair care routine is a hair oil. This is my every single day hair oil, and it is the Verb Ghost Oil. This is what it looks like. As you guys can see, I'm pretty much done the product. I'm here right now. I just think this is such a great everyday hair oil. First of all, the smell is pretty subtle. It's not too strong. It's not non-existent either. So I really prefer this ghost oil, and it just makes your hair look even shinier, especially midday or like if you want to carry it around. Sometimes I actually carry my hair oils around. So this is my everyday one. Now, for my special occasion one, I have the Kérastase Chronologiste Hair Perfume / Oil, and this is what it looks like. This hair oil I only use on special occasions because the smell is quite strong. I love the smell. That's why it's also advertised as an oil / perfume. Because this bottle is so, so, so expensive compared to the Verb, this is definitely your affordable everyday product. But this one, because it's so expensive, I don't use it every day, especially if I'm not seeing anyone, especially during quarantine. Why do I need to use a fancy smelling super good hair oil? You know what I mean? But if I'm going on a date, or if I'm seeing someone special, like my parents, or like Teresa, my podcast partner, I'm just kidding. You know what I mean? On really special occasions, I will use this one because I already have a good everyday hair oil, so I don't need to go into my super expensive bottle. That is pretty much my every wash hair routine, from shampoo all the way to hair oil. Now I'm gonna talk about my hair routine when it comes to just like every week and maintaining color and hydration and texture and stuff like that. So to kick us off, I have my very favorite purple shampoo, and this one is the No Yellow Shampoo. This is what it looks like. I actually made a TikTok video / Instagram reel on this. The way that I use this product and why it's my favorite is because it is an extremely strong and fast acting purple shampoo. If you want to get the job done really, really fast and you also just don't have time to sit around, this is the product I use. And the way that I use it is on dirty, dry hair. Keyword, dry and dirty. You don't wanna like wash your hair while it's already washed, I guess. So on dirty, dry hair, I will actually lather this all over my hair. I will just let it sit dry for sometimes 20 minutes, 30 minutes. The reason why I don't wanna recommend it to everybody is because I have quite thick hair. My strands are really thick, and it's not gonna make it super, super dry. It's okay for me. If you have really fine hair, please, please, please take this method with a grain of salt, or leave it on for very little time, or just use it on wet hair. Do it on dry hair if you are confident, or just test run it. Do not just try this, because I've test run it, you know, the first time I did it for 5 minutes, then I did it for 10 minutes, etc. But basically, I would put this on my dry hair, let it sit for a couple of minutes, and then wash it out. Then that's kind of how I do my usual hair routine. And I do this about once a week or once every 2 weeks, just because I am so, so, so busy. I just don't don't have time to be sitting in the shower and doing this for a really long time, which is why I prefer the dry method. Now, if you're also gonna be using this method, make sure you either wear gloves, or for me, because I really care about the environment, I actually don't wear gloves. I actually just put it on my bare hands. But what I do to get off the purple shampoo is on my still dry hands, I'll put makeup cleansing oil and balm, and I will just rinse off my hand, and it pretty much removes everything, even though it is a little bit expensive because you are using your cleansing oil. Okay, so after I use the purple shampoo, I will actually go in as my once a week routine and use the Kérastase Chronologique pre-wash. And this is what it looks like. This is the pre-shampoo. You actually use this right before you shampoo your hair. I personally describe this method as kind of like exfoliating your hair or your scalp. I do this once a week as well because I actually find that my hair gets oily a lot less. So that's why I will always do this once a week, because I can actually sustain 3 nights or at least 1 or 2 more nights without washing my hair when I use a pre-shampoo. And if you exfoliate your face, you exfoliate your body, why wouldn't you exfoliate your scalp? You know what I mean? If you guys want to have your hair last longer so you're not washing as often, I definitely recommend trying a pre-shampoo. This is just the one that I use, but you're free to use any other brand. I really like that one. This one is super effective on my hair. Especially on the days that I do the purple shampoo method, I will for sure do a hydrating mask. And the mask that I use is the Verb Manage and Restore Hydrating Mask. This is what it looks like. And I'm gonna tell you guys why I love this mask so much. Number one, this mask, obviously, when you are doing such a hair drying method, you need to mask your hair. So I use this one. The second reason that I like this is because so many masks in the hair industry, for some reason, are in a pot. And when I'm showering and stuff, I just don't like when the mask is in a pot. The ones that I do have that is in a pot, I actually leave it beside my bathtub and use it when I'm taking a bath. On the days that I'm like in a shower and not a bath, I will for sure use this one, because not only is the product amazing and I don't have to leave it for that long compared to some of the other masks, I feel like this one works pretty fast. And second of all, the applicator, or not even applicator, the packaging just makes it so much easier to do a hair mask, and I don't have to dig my dirty hands into a pot and then like know that I've touched the inside of the products. Anyway, that's just a preference. And like I said, I do it for my bath. I'm already getting ready to go in, so I'm not really having such dirty hands when I put on a mask. So that's pretty much my once a week routine. Those are the products for my once a week routine. Now I'm gonna go into the products that I'll use on occasion, depending on what the situation is. Starting with their volume line. I already have a little bit of volume because I have a little bit of natural waves. I don't have your classic silky, straight Asian hair. For me, I already have a little bit of volume. However, on the days that I want to look really extra, or on the days where I've already slept in my hair and I didn't wash my hair the night before and I need to kind of like re-volumize my hair, I will use their new line. And you guys, this line, I used it one time, and I will leave an Instagram picture here. My hair was like so hot. I can't show you today because I wanted to show you guys my hair right after I washed it and did the whole curl routine. This revives your hair so well. I guess I could also have used it today, but I usually use it more on the second day. Number one, we have the Full Body Weightless Lift Volume Spray, and this is what it looks like. And actually, I'm just gonna show you how it works. For this one, I think it works extremely well, especially if you have straight hair, because it's intended for you to spray from top all the way to the bottom. For me, I just need to focus on the top to give me volume. If your hair is like almost too silky, if you know what I mean, like you can't curl it or whatever, you wanna maintain the style, I really recommend this one because you can spray it all throughout. And do you already see how this is already staying? But anyway. The second one is their Root Lift and Hold. This product is mostly for the roots. This one also works really well just to hold the roots together. If you want the texture for the body of your hair, use this product. And then for this product, it is to help you lift up your hair. Like I said, refer to my Instagram picture because I can't make this stuff up. My hair was just so much higher. I don't know how they do it. But anyway, this is the volume line. They also have a dry shampoo line. So they have their regular dry shampoo, which I've tried before as well. I'm not a huge dry shampoo person, but they have their regular one, but they also have their new volume one. So I feel like this one's a pretty good two-in-one. If you're looking for your dry shampoo and you want volume on, especially days that your hair has fallen flat after not washing it for a little bit, I highly, highly recommend checking these out because this is such a good two-in-one. Now, the last product that I really like from them, and I've actually reviewed this product before already in a previous YouTube video, but because this video is a holistic video, I'm just gonna bring it back anyway. It is the Verb Tone and Brighten Purple Mask. So the reason why I like this product is because having to leave your hair in to do a purple shampoo and then having to leave your hair in again for a mask is like double the time. So on days where you're in a rush, but you want to do both of these methods and you don't have the time to wait around, then I highly recommend this one. It's both a mask and a purple shampoo all in one together. That way you can hydrate your hair while toning your hair. That's also why I like it, because on days that I'm in a rush but I want to kind of do the two-step method and I don't have time, then I will just use this product. So anyway, I know this was a super long video, but I wanted to go through end to end exactly what I use every single hair wash or once a week, because ever since I incorporated all these products, and I know that there's a lot, but trust me, my hair has become so much healthier and I just feel like overall it's become a lot smoother. I've never loved my hair this much as I do present day. Once again, this is all thanks to Verb, and as usual, I have a partnership with them, so you guys can use my discount code for 10% off in the link down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys have any more questions, please feel free to leave them down below, and if you haven't already, subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!